Hi my dear students, welcome back to our maths class. Today we are going to start our new chapter, Equal Sharing. In this chapter we are going to discuss about division. Let's start our class. Division. You had already studied in your lower classes that division is repeated subtraction. Now we shall do a textual activity. When 56 sweets were distributed among the groups of 5B, each group got 8 sweets. How many groups were there? How will you calculate the number of groups? Let's split 56 sweets into sets of 8. 1 8 is 8, 2 8s are 16. 3 8s are 24, 4 8s are 32, 5 8s are 40, 6 8s are 48, 7 8s are 56. How many sets of sweets? Yes, it is 7. So, class 5B is divided into how many groups? Yes, it is 7. Do you have any idea to find out the number of groups without actually splitting the sweets as above? Yes, 8 multiplied by what number gives 56? It is 7. So, what number do we get on doing 56 by 8? That is 56 divided by 8 equal 7, because 8 into 7 is 56. Now we shall do a division work with a 2-digit number. Do you know how to divide the numbers? 24 divided by 4. How will you divide 24 by 4? Do you know how to divide? 24 divided by 4. How will you divide this number? 4 into which number gives 24? 4 into 6 equals 24. Then write 6 here. 4 into 6 is 24. Then subtract these numbers. 4 minus 4 is 0. 2 minus 2 is 0. Then the answer you got is 6. These all numbers have some names. The number which is divided is called by the name dividend. Here 24 is the dividend. Next, what about 4? The number by which the dividend is divided is called divisor. Here which is the divisor? Yes. Here, 4 is the divisor. When dividend is divided by divisor, the answer you got is called quotient. Which is the quotient here? Yes, it is 6. Write the quotient 6. Then, any balance or the number which can't be able to divide is called by the name remainder. Q represents quotient and R represents remainder. Here, remainder equal 0. Have you all understood this? Then, we shall go for a textual activity. The table below shows the number of groups some classes are divided into and the number of sweets given to these classes. Fill in the missing details. In class 5C, the number of sweets are 70 and the number of groups are 5. Then number of sweets for each group equal 70 divided by 5. The answer you got is 14. Then in 6A, number of sweets are 96 and the number of seats for each group is 8. Then, how will you find the number of groups? 96 divided by 8 equal 12. In 6B, the number of seats are 84 and the number of groups are 6. Then the number of seats for each group equal 84 divided by 6. That is equal to 14. Then in 6C, number of seats are not given. Number of groups and number of seats for each group is given. Number of groups equal 7 and number of seats for each group equal 12. Then the number of seats equal 7 into 12 equal 84. Is it clear for you? Now we shall do a word problem. Question number 1. The total price of 7 pence is 98 rupees, all of the same prices. What is the price of 1 pen? How will you find the answer? The total price of 7 pence is given as 98. Price of 7 pence equal how much? 98 rupees. Then how will you find the price of 1 pen? We have to divide 98 by 7. Then price of 1 pen equal 98 divided by 7. How will you divide this number? Yes, 98 divided by 7. Divide the numbers one by one. Can you divide 9 by 7? How many times? 1 times. 1 into 7 is 7. Then 9 minus 7 is 2. Then what will you do? Bring the 8 here. Then the number becomes 28. Then 28 divided by 7. 7 into which number gives 28? Yes, it is 4. Then 74 equal 28. 28 minus 28 is 0. Then the answer you got is rupees 14. Then the price of 1 pen equal rupees 14. Have you all understood this? Now question number 2. Amal bought 6 notebooks, all of the same price. He gave 100 rupee note and the shopkeeper gave him 4 rupees back. What is the price of a notebook? How will you find this? Here, in this question, the total price of 6 notebooks is not given. It is given that Amal had given 100 rupee notes and the shopkeeper gave him 4 rupees back as balance. Then what is the price of 6 notebooks? It is 100 rupees minus 4. What will you get on subtracting 4 from 100? Count the 4 numbers backwards. 99, 98, 97, 96. Then 100 minus 4 is 96. Then the price of 6 notebooks is rupees 96. Then the price of 1 notebook equal. How will you find this? Yes, the price of 6 notebooks divided by the number of notebooks, that is 96 divided by 6. Let's calculate. 96 divided by 6 divide the numbers one by one. First of all, 9 divided by 6. How many times? 1 time, 1 into 6 is 6. Then 9 minus 6 is 3. Then bring the 6 downwards. The number becomes 36. Then 36 divided by 6. 6 into which number is 36? Yes, it is 6. Then 6 into 6 equal 36. 36 minus 36 is 0. Then write the answer we got. That is rupees 16. Therefore, the price of one notebook equal rupees 16. That's all for today, children. Today, there are two homeworks for you. Do it well. Okay? Thank you.